Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this sixth episode of Ask Advancells, the new web series that we have started to interact more with our target audience, to make you understand, to answer your questions and answer your questions specifically on regenerative medicine. If you still don't know me, my name is Vipul Jain. I'm the founder and CEO of Advancells, India's premier institute for manufacturing of cells and application of cellular medicine in clinical outcomes. Today, we thought we are going to talk about one of our most requested procedures, and which is for treatment of diabetes. Specifically, we are going to talk about diabetes type 2, which is also known as adult diabetes, and usually shows up in adults. Just to clearly identify between juvenile diabetes, which is known as diabetes type 1. So we are going to be talking more about diabetes type 2 today. So diabetes, according to me, is one of the most underrated yet critical illnesses that humankind faces. Diabetes type 2, to be very specific, is a more of a lifestyle disease. It takes place in most of the cases, almost 80% of the cases, 80% of the people who suffer from diabetes type 2. They do that either because it's hereditary or because bad lifestyle. And more than anything else, it is the bad lifestyle that leads us to diabetes type 2. When we are young, when we are too busy in work, when we are too busy enjoying our life, we unfortunately make some bad life choices, such as bad food, bad life habits, not enough exercise, all those kind of things. And unfortunately, diabetes is something that you can get because of these bad life choices. Usually when we think of diabetes, people get scared, but they get scared because they think that, oh God, from now on, I won't be able to eat sweets. From now on, I'll have to alter my lifestyle. I'll have to take a medicine every day. But they don't understand that this is not a disease that you can contain by just taking a medicine. It keeps on progressing. It keeps on growing inside the body. And slowly and gradually, by first taking one medicine a day, you get to two medicines a day, three medicines a day, four medicines a day, you get onto insulin, and that's when really the disease becomes huge. It can affect your vital organs, it can affect your kidneys, your eyes, your liver, your heart. It reduces your immunity against wound healing. People reach a stage where a simple wound becomes so big because it's not healing that limbs have to be amputated. Surgeries cannot be performed till the time diabetes is in check. Imagine if somebody is in a trauma and urgent surgery is required. Doctors have to wait 2 to 3 days till the time diabetes is brought under control, and only then they can operate. Huge mortality rate because of that. What are the conventional available ways to treat diabetes? First of all, there is no treatment for diabetes. Diabetes cannot be treated. It can be managed. That's the real truth. If you are taking medication for diabetes, if you're taking insulin for diabetes, you're basically keeping diabetes in check. Your diabetes is not getting treated. Unfortunately, there is no treatment available. There is no way in conventional medicine that diabetes can be finished. Sure, you can try things like Ayurveda, homeopath. Definitely, changing your eating habits, changing your lifestyle helps. But once diabetes enters the system, it is very, very difficult to keep it contained. Stem cells, on the other hand, regenerative medicine does provide some hope in reversing this disease, or at least containing this disease for a long time. The way stem cells help on the cellular level, the way they help in rejuvenating the pancreas, it has proven, there have been a lot of papers that have been published all over the world, which has shown that diabetes has got reversed in both animal and human models when the stem cells are transplanted inside the human body. Now, when I say that they are transplanted inside the human body, it is extremely, extremely important to remember the three questions that you always need to ask about regenerative medicine. What is the right type of cells that we need to transplant? What is the right quantity of cells that we need to transplant? And where do we exactly need to transplant the cells? If you meet regenerative medicine practitioners across the world, a lot of them will tell you that they are going to give you IV of cells, and that will help you in curing diabetes. Let me put things on record here and say that does not help. Taking an IV in diabetes will not help. What is required is proper transplantation of cells, proper guided delivery of cells to the pancreas. Only when that happens, we see results happening. When we see that not happening, very, very seldom, very, very rare do we see any kind of result. So it is very important that you make sure, if you are considering cellular therapy, if you're considering regenerative medicine for diabetes, you always ask the three questions. What is the right kind of cells? What is the right quantity of cells? And how they are going to be put back into the body? And if you're seeking treatment for diabetes and the answer is that they are going to give you IV, don't go for it. It's not going to make any difference. Always choose a place, always choose the modality where cells are transplanted onto your pancreas. It's a little invasive method, but it's a very simple, very small procedure. We usually keep a patient overnight in the hospital, and the next day you are back at form, and things are going well from there. So please consider diabetes as a serious disease. It's not a disease that you can take lightly. Please consider regenerative medicine as an option to get diabetes treated. If you're considering that, please make sure that the cells in the right quality, in the right quantity, are implanted at the right place. If you have any questions for us, please feel free to ask, tweet about us, share this video if you want. Let us know what you think about it. We are always here to answer your questions, and I look forward to seeing you again next week. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.